Dharavi is one of the most densely populated places on earth. And in a dark, damp corner of this sprawling neighborhood, Pushpa Muthuraj and her family are working hard to better their lives. Pushpa's one-room home doesn't have running water or a reliable supply of electricity, but it's filled with grit, determination, and a steady stream of homework.
My husband and I are working hard to make sure our daughters' lives are better than ours. We are sending them to a private school so that they get good education. I just want them to have good lives.
While Pushpa supervises this daily study session, upstairs her husband Muthuraj is trying to make ends meet. Working as a tailor, he earns around $170 a month.
If my daughters do well, it will be good for us too. If they work hard and study, when they grow up, they will get good jobs and look after us.
Pushpa's daughters are her biggest investment, and 13-year-old Satya is well aware of the price her parents are paying so that she can see a world beyond Dharavi.
For us, they are not eating. We are studying well because of them. I want to give the best when I become teacher. I want to give the best for them.
People do business, raise families, and live their daily lives in exceptionally close quarters here. And it's this sense of closeness, these flimsy buildings, and a lack of sanitation that the Indian government says makes Dharavi unfit for humans to live in. When Pushpa's not raising her daughters, she's trying to make the unlivable bearable as a community worker. People who live in Mumbai are known for being able to spot an opportunity in the most unlikely of places. This includes Dharavi. And like millions of others who call India's financial capital home, Pushpa believes that if she can make it here, she can make it anywhere. Nididat, Al Jazeera, Mumbai.